It's gonna be an incredible night. We're in for a lot of fun. We're in for a lot of Jesus. I remember my mama walking through the house when I was a kid. She'd say, Jesus, 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 Jesus. And I thought, man, she has a snack fetish. Then I figured it out, knew what was going on. It's gonna be an incredible night. And to get it going and to get it started, please make welcome your hostess for the night, Miss Helena.
Draggin' for Jesus. The theme this year is give me strength. And how many times have I heard my mommy say that having to deal with me when I was growing up?
Strength.
What am I gonna do with that?
That girl's a killing me.
That girl. No, she never did say that. God rest her soul, if she is here now, she might. But she never did say that girl's a, well, she might have said it, I just didn't hear it. Anyway, it's so good to see you all. Thank you all for being here. This, I'm kind of assuming everybody knows why we're here, but briefly, I'm not gonna talk too much. Because we've got a lot of wonderful talent here tonight, and I'm so excited. The cool thing about this thing, this Grace Fest, people approach me. I barely even have to go to people and say, will you do this? Because they approach me and they say, Mamaw, they call me Mamaw. Mamaw, that's why I wore my gray hair tonight. Y'all like my gray hair? Celebrate 50 and over, yes. They say, Mamaw, we would love to be part of your show. We've heard about it. We know that it's kind of a big deal. You raise money for kids. Every dollar that you tip us with, or every check that you write, or whatever, there's not any kind of accounting fees, or we're going to keep this little piece out, or you know, there's none of that goes on. Every single dollar of that. Last year we told you every dollar that was going to go toward feeding children. That's what we've said every year. But you know what? Year after year after year, y'all get a little bit more generous, and we raise a little bit more money. And last year, not to put pressure on y'all or anything, but last year we raised $9,000. Right?
That's as much as the Trump Foundation.
That's that right now. We ain't going there. So
I got it in.
He got it in. That's what she said. So. You know better. I know. Here comes the roar. Look, I already said I'm over 50. My train of thought derails real easy.
Jesus.
But anyway, this is such a wonderful show. We keep getting girls in that want to do this. They know it's a big deal. All of it was supposed to go toward feeding kids. Well, guess what? We had more money than we had the avenue to feed kids with all that money. So this year, this is what we're doing, and I just want y'all to know about it. So first of all, my heart is about children. I don't like to see a child and even think about a child being hungry. That doesn't work for me. There is no reason with all the people in this room, that's just the people in this room, all the people in the city, the state, this country, there is no reason why any child should ever be hungry.
Amen. Okay.
That insults me when I hear that a child is hungry. We'll feed that young man, and let's figure out how. So, hunger is not the only thing that children need. So we, Pastor Marcia and I had a conversation, and we have had a few things come forward, a few situations come to us where a child could be helped in other ways. And Marcia actually will tell you more about that a little bit later. And we have leftover money from last year. And I just said, that's a no-brainer. Do it. Let's do it. So we have formed at Bluegrass United Church of Christ. I'm proud to be a member of BUCC. Any church that loves me just the way I am, bless their hearts. It's a wonderful thing. And you know what? God does love us just right where we are. Right where we are right now. Amen. Right who you are right now. It's a journey, honey. We're all on that journey. We're finding ourselves. Sorry. Maybe I'll get a little long-winded. I swore I wasn't going to do that. I'm going to start preaching here in a minute. Anyway, we decided that we wanted to set up a fund with this money. And it's still going to be handled the same way, but it's going to be in a separate fund, just like the backpack program was. And backpack program is going to be the number one priority out of that fund. That's not going to change. We're going to feed those kids. With whatever monies we have left over, as situations where children have a need come to us, we're going to have a committee that's going to discuss that. And if it feels right, we're going to take care of that need. And the fund is going to be called Kids Count. Do you like it? Okay. First tears, here we go. Kids do count. We were all kids once, and we grew up to be this. And guess what those kids that you see are going to grow up to be? They're going to grow up to be you, and you, and you, and they're going to find themselves, and they're going to be living struggles we can't even imagine right now. So we've got to take care of those kids so that when they're thinking about who they are, and they're trying to grow up to be what they're supposed to be, and accept themselves and each other, they're not doing it with a hungry belly, or because they can't see the chalkboard at school because they don't have, can't afford glasses. Okay? Right? Okay, so. Oh. Drag droppings. I will sell you that fake finger for $100. Who's dead? Okay, anyway, that's why we're here. I did get long-winded. And I'm not the only one that's hosting this show tonight. So please give it up for my co-host. I could not do this show without him. Would not want to do this show without him. He's the amazing Mr. Kenny Bishop. Please give him a hand. As a matter of fact, I think I'm going to go down there and sit beside him.
Come down here, darling. We'll save you a seat.
I got right down the steps without falling. I'm so pleased. Okay.
Well, here, I didn't get to give this to you earlier. Everybody likes to tip Miss Helena, because you know she's getting old. You never know when it might be the last time.
Might be your last time. I might have to whip your ass. Like a mamma said, honey. How many of y'all have had your ass whipped by your mamma?
See?
I will whip your ass. Don't go there. Okay. Well, we're going to go ahead. I'm going to hush. We're going to talk more to you about what's going on. But please feel free to write those checks. All that you donate tonight is going to go toward that fund. There's not one penny of that that anybody on the stage or in our church is going to keep for ourselves. Every penny of it is going to go to help those kids. And that happens because of you, not because of us. We just get up here and do a couple little numbers and dress up pretty and have a good time. It's you all that make that happen. So feel proud when you leave here tonight. If you donated $1 or $10,000, I'll take that check. But whatever you came in here and donated tonight, every penny of that's going to make a difference. So go ahead, go home with your head held high and be proud of yourself that you were here. Thank you for being here. We love you all. Let's bring to the stage our next performer. This is her first year doing Praise Fest with us. She has kind of taken the community by storm. She has been so involved with the Imperial Court, with all kinds of different organizations, and she just performs her heart out, not to mention the fact that she's just absolutely stunning. Please welcome to the stage, everyone, Miss Serena Van Deren. Thank you.
Helena Handbasket. How about it? A beautiful lady and a beautiful song.
Yeah, buddy. I told you she's pretty, ain't she? She's right pretty. If I didn't love her so much, I'd hate her for being so skinny. Can somebody get her a sandwich? I love you, girl. Thank you for being here. Oh, my goodness. Well, we had a little challenge, and I'm going to bring someone to the stage or up here with me right now. Where's Pam? Where is Pam? So y'all, this is way outside her comfort zone. So you know how I told the story about how I got flipped in the back of the head by God and he said, go raise that money for those hungry children. And by the way, the first year, our goal was $1,000 and we did $3,400 that day. So when God, you know, God was showing out, he was acting out. I loved it. So we get this show scheduled for this year. And this one, who's not really, really comfortable in front of everybody, unless she's preaching and then she's comfortable. She knows what, she can preach a sermon, let me tell you, she's wonderful. Well, she came up to me and she said, you know that story about how God flipped me in the back of the head? God flipped me in the back of the head and said, if you can get $1,000 in pledges before Praise Fest, then Anthony, I will let you put me in a wig and heels and big old drag queen paint face, and I will get up there and do a number. That's what she said. Well, Pam, I have to tell you, when we got to church this morning, we only had $275 in pledges, and I'm sorry. But she agreed to do it anyway if we didn't raise the money. However, at this point, we are up to $1,450. So I'm going to send her away right now. And the next time you see Pam, it's not going to be Pam. It's going to be Sexy Hot Sunday. Yeah!
I think I saw one of these makeover things like on the Today Show.
Really?
Yeah, like they pick somebody out of the audience and they bring them in and they do them all up and make them over and just like turn them into somebody entirely different.
You know what I'd like to say right now in front of God and everybody? You know what I'm thinking? That's a good idea. I love the Today Show and I love being able to do that. We should make the claim right now before next year's show that if, after this show's over, if I can get $5,000 worth of checks in the next year mailed to our church with Praise Fest in the bottom of it, we ought to see if we could get our pastor to get up and let us. If you send BUCC a check for Praise Fest 2017, if we get $5,000 in the next year, will you do it, Marsha?
I'm retired.
Oh, no, you're not. Marsha McBean, tell her. Church outside the box.
She's going to do it.
She's going to do it?
Yeah.
The challenge is on. We need to start next year's Praise Fest with a beginning balance of $5,000. Let's do this. Okay, we're moving on. I love it when I just think on my feet. Oh wait, I'm sitting down.
Yeah, I love it when God hits Marsha in the back of the head and you translate. Just like speaking in tongues in the church I grew up.
I was gonna say, from your Pentecostal faith, you're right, that makes perfect sense to you, doesn't it?
Let me tell you what God's saying.
Well, yeah, let me tell you what God's saying. Marsha, God's saying, put on a big old dress and do a number. The $5,000. Okay. She's gonna hate me. Oh, I'm glad the spotlight's in my face because I can't see her reaction. So this is good.
She's smiling.
She's smiling good. Thank you. Thank you, Stephen. Let's move this thing on. We're gonna be here all night if I don't hush. Bring to the stage our next performer, everybody. I have to tell you, this is the very first time I've seen her perform. But he is a member of our church, and he used to be a very popular entertainer up in Ohio, where they moved here from, and said, I would come out of retirement and do a little number if you wanted me to. And I said, honey, I've seen pictures of you. You're beautiful. Woo! Absolutely. You're on. Let's do this. Please welcome to the stage, everybody, Jameson Brooks. Woo!
She can eat.
Yeah, right, that's true. I don't know where she puts it. I ain't going there. Has everyone met our sister that's with us tonight?
Yeah.
I'd like to introduce you to Sister Noella De Ruler. Because she knows well the ruler. Get it? Noella De Ruler. Okay. If I have to explain it, it's not funny. How are you tonight, sister?
I am so good to see my child. I've known Miss Helena since she was reaction jumbo. I said, child, I'm gonna grow up and be something. And you are something. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Yeah, I'm something. Something else. And I love the fact that you're just passing the plate and bringing checks. They can give you checks in these baskets and you'll bring them up here to me, right? And I don't see any checks, but I see some cash. You want to empty it into the trunk and get for us?
If they do not get the cash, they will Noella De Ruler.
If they don't get the cash, they will Noella De Ruler. Okay, well, you go get them, honey. Thank you, Noella. Big hand for Noella De Ruler. Second year here. Maybe the third year we'll get her on stage doing a little sister act number or something. See if we can't find a couple nuns with her. John Ainsbergen and Dean. I'm just saying, might as well get everybody in the act. Oh my goodness. So this next performer we've got coming up, everybody, I am so honored that she's here with us tonight. There is so much I could say because I'm impressed by so many different things about this next person. Impressed by this person as a person, impressed by them from a performance angle, and this is not the only performance that this person does. And I've been blessed enough to get to witness the other kind of performance than this person does, and it's amazing.
I don't even know where you're going there.
It's amazing. Let's just put it this way. There is a voice under that hair that is just amazing.
Amen.
So, amen, right? Those of you that know who this is, you already know. So please bring to the stage, I'm so proud to call her my friend and my sister, Miss Sasha Greenberg.
Our Lord of all the earth, Lord, pray.
We tell them all the time, it's really like going to church. And sometimes they look at you like you're out of your head.
Right.
You know, but then when something like that happens, it just, it proves it. It's church.
It is church. Speaking of church, we had church this morning, didn't we?
We had good church this morning.
You know, I tell people, y'all have heard this before, but I grew up Catholic Baptist. My daddy was Catholic, my mommy was Baptist, and my sister was Pentecostal. Pretty sure that's why I'm sitting here in this dress. But anyway. I'm going to shout in a minute, and there's going to be bobby pins just a flying everywhere.
Don't run ahead.
Like my Aunt Gertie. Oh, God bless your soul. Hi, Aunt Gertie. Gertie, ain't I? Okay. But we have church this morning, and you know, you just never know what's going to happen when you bring a pastor up on stage. Please welcome everybody. She is our pastor, Miss Marcia Moores Charles.
Kenny says it's called, we started singing like some Pentecostals up there this morning. Yeah, we did. Our opening hymn was How Great Is Our God. And then we went right into how great thou art, and whoa, I tell you what, we could have just gone to the house after that.
Woo!
It was great. Thank y'all for being here. Anthony, I want to say to you, buddy. Anthony came to me the very first year of our church. We're only 5 years old, which is amazing when you think about our church. And at that time, our offerings were about $150 a week. Bonnie Meek came to me, said, Marsh, there's a need. There's some kids hungry here in Lexington, and they need to feed with backpacks. A backpack, if y'all wonder what that is, they go to their family resource center on Friday, and they get a pack, and it feeds them Friday night, three meals Saturday, three meals Sunday. And we packed well over 50,000 backpacks. And I said, Bonnie, how much will cost? She said, $1,000. We have about 20 members, $150 a week average offering. I said, well, tell them we'll do it. Had no clue how we were going to raise money. She came back about 6 weeks later, said, I got some bad news. I said, what? She said, the other two churches that we're going to chip in with us, they're out. It's going to be $3,000. I said, tell them we'll do it. Had no clue. Announced it in church. This one comes up to me after church. She said, I can raise you that money. I said, all right, how? He said, well, I'm going to transform from Anthony to Helena, and I've seen Helena, and we're going to have a drag show. I said, let me get back to you on that. Even for a progressive little preacher rebel like me, that was pretty out there. And Brendan will tell you, I was a nervous wreck the first year, thinking, my oh my, how's this going to be received? And I walked into that seedy little bar on Winchester Road. It's since gone out, by the way. And I had a good friend of mine that came, and he said, is this a fundraiser for y'all or for the bar? I've never seen this many people at the bar. And as Anthony said, we raised over $3,000 that first year. And I'm going to tell you, I'll share this with everybody. I grew up Southern Baptist, and I've been in churches all my life. I had never experienced church like I did that year, and every year we have this, I look forward to it. This is church up in here. We are so blessed at Bluegrass with a lot of folks. By the way, it's Pam Miller that made that little challenge. She's an elder at our church. And Michael, who's walking around as the nun, he's an elder at our church. Cindy Terry is an elder at our church, sitting right here, tipping these queens. And I tell you what, I'm proud of this. I have to say it, Miss Hattie. Miss Hattie. Over on Donetta Drive, and I don't think they knew what they was getting into. But I tell you what, they blessed us, and yes. I hope we bless them. We love you both. We love all y'all. We're glad you're here. Tonight, I've asked Kenny to join me. Kenny and I love to sing together.
We do.
We've been singing a little bit in Nashville together.
Miss Hattie says she loves you all too.
All right. And the song we're going to sing tonight is a song that I wrote, and it's especially moving to me tonight because I wrote this song when we were trying to decide what to do at the church, whether to renovate, you know, what decisions to make. And that was going through my head, but what was really going through my head is one of my very, very best friends, Peggy Alderhart, who's here with us tonight, a member of our church. Peggy had just been diagnosed with ovarian cancer, and it really took Brenda and I for a real ride. And so I went to Lake Junaluska, North Carolina, and attended my good friend, Dr. Marsha McPhee, who's also here with us from Tahoe tonight. Marsha always inspires me, and we have a free time on Tuesday morning, and I sit at a piano, and I only play by ear. I don't read a lick of music. And I sit at a piano, and I was thinking about Peggy, and I was thinking about the church. And I had that time of inspiration, and I wrote this song called Make Me Whole. And I'm thrilled that Kenny's going to sing with me, and I is recorded with me.
It's my honor.
Give it up, everybody. Marcia, Morris, Charles, and Kenny Bishop. Oh my goodness. Marcia, what a gift. That was beautiful, honey. Thank you so much. Oh. So we've got a good preacher, and she sings too. How about that? We love that. So just to throw this out there real quick, everybody, I keep getting these wonderful little pieces of paper. Oh my goodness, here's another one. So there's a little piece of paper that says $100 on it. There's one that says $250. That one says $250. That one says $50. There's another $250. I'm seeing a trend. There's another $250.
Wow.
And this one, just because I know this lesbian couple, they wanted to just challenge some other lesbian couples. Said, girls, bring it. You can bring $100 per person in the couple. So $200 challenge to the lesbian couples in the room from Sherry and Brandy. Thank you. It's a challenge. Come on.
I didn't know they were lesbian.
Get your checkbook.
I didn't know they were lesbian.
They told me they were. Was I not supposed to tell? Y'all didn't know, did y'all? I outed y'all right here at the show. I'm sorry. Gosh, nobody knew until I said it. I'm sorry, Sherry, don't kick my ass.
I wonder what man burned.
Oh, another piece of paper. I love that. Another piece of paper for $100. We love it. These pieces of paper for $1 are fine too. We'll take whatever you got to give us. We love you for it. All right, well, let's keep this thing going or we're going to be here all night long. Please bring to the stage our next performer, everybody. I performed with her, had the pleasure of performing with her, lots of different events, lots of different bars in town, and she always brings it. She's a joy, and we love her. Please welcome Miss Georgia Peach.
My heart's torn in pieces.
right ahead and get those chips. That's okay. We got some more papers. So the cutest thing just happened. Somebody had given me a $100 check earlier, and then that challenge went out. And doggone it, they didn't just bring me up another $100 check. They wasn't going to get beat out. Where are you, Liz and Jean? I love it. So we got the challenge map right there. Love it. Thank you all. Lynn Fitzgerald, $100. God bless you, honey. We got a check. This one came from a girl that doesn't even live in this state. And she heard us talking about it in church this morning. And she came up after church and handed me this check. She said, I can't be there, but here, I want to donate. $25. We'll take it. Here's another $100. Here's another $80. We love it. $25. We love you all. Thank you all for this so much. You're feeding hungry youngins, taking care of babies. I love y'all. Let's bring to the stage our next performer, everybody. You know, we are an equal opportunity. Just because we drag queens get a whole lot of attention, we are not the only performers that are out there. We just sort of suck up all most of the attention, whatever. Well, did I say something bad?
I'm not saying anything. All I heard was attention.
We suck up the attention. Shut up. Go on. Y'all dirty minded. Y'all hush. I still don't know what I said. But anyway, we've got a wonderful drag king who performs in the community, and we are so glad that he is here with us tonight. Please welcome Kenneth Fire.
And you journey on.
Wow.
Next year.
All right. Thank you, Kenneth. That was wonderful. Give it up. Give it to Jay Swire. Yes. I swear, I tell myself every year I'm not going to be long-winded, and then I get here and it does turn into the Jerry Lewis telethon. I hope you brought your potatoes. So, I want to bring somebody up here just real quick. They don't even know that I'm going to do this, but I'm going to do this. Carol and Michelle, would you please come up here? So we've talked about the backpack program. Now let me tell you what that involves. Every month, somebody has to go buy all of this food, haul all of this food to the church, unload all this church out of their all this food out of their van, bring it into the church, set it all up so that we can easily just go down the line and put food in a little bag, tie it in a knot, put it in a big Rubbermaid container. At which time we've got how many Rubbermaid containers?
Oh, we've got 24, but we fill 12 each time.
We fill 12 each time. So these two wonderful people end up taking these 12 heavy, remember, each one has 8 to 10 of these backpack things of food in there. They carry it, we all carry it to their car. They have to deliver it to the school. You all have done an amazing job and we appreciate y'all so much. Carol, make all this work. Thank you all so much. We love you. Thank you. Amazing, amazing ladies.
Yes, so proud. You know, somebody that I've gotten to know really well, somebody who's become a vital part, an important part of what goes on at BUCC, is our next performer. Who? She's become a dear friend, and I've gotten to know her heart, and I've gotten to know. Gotten to really appreciate her spirit, and she steps up a lot of things, especially a lot of our social events and things at the church. She steps up and coordinates them. He steps up and coordinates them and puts them all together. She's here tonight. What a beautiful, beautiful spirit and a beautiful heart. My dear friend is Cadillac Seville.
Janelle.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Cadillac. That was wonderful, baby. Well, I just saw somebody up here tipping that actually I've not even had the pleasure of meeting yet, but I know who he is, and I'm going to call him out and embarrass him. His name, I think his name is J.R. Sierkowski.
J.R.
Did I say that right?
Yeah.
Where is he? Where is he hiding? I'm calling him out. There's going to be some kind of an interfaith service?
A community interfaith Thanksgiving service.
And on November 3rd?
On November the 3rd at St. Paul Catholic Church. And JR is putting all of the program together. It's going to be a beautiful. Go ahead and get it on your calendars if you can.
Here he is.
Here he is.
Come on up, JR.
So tell us.
I didn't know you were going to be put on the spot, did you?
Tell us. Welcome to the Jim and Tammy Faye Show.
I'm going to cry. Mascara tears running down my face.
He said, that's okay, I'm going to pee in a minute. JR, tell us a little bit about the service real quick.
Sure. Well, I hope you all come. It's at St. Paul's Church, and I know that it's not every day that you get an invitation to a Catholic church, but we'll have some very friendly Catholics there. We'll have some Muslim sisters and brothers. We'll have Jewish sisters and brothers. We'll have some Buddhist sisters and brothers. We will have all kinds of different flavors of Christian sisters and brothers. And we're just all going to say a big thank you to Almighty God for everything, for the goodness here tonight. Especially, we have something tremendous to thank God for. I've never seen anything like this, and I've been in ministry for 30 years. So, which I know is very difficult for you to believe since I look so young. But I have to congratulate Marcia and all of you for doing this. Please come to St. Paul's and show the rest of our community what it means to be in solidarity and where diversity is in fact a tremendous blessing. We all need to learn that. And you've taught me that, and Marcia's taught me that, and now it's time for us to take it out beyond here, and let's move it into the community and keep telling everybody that. Please come.
Thank you, JR. Thank you so much.
And you know,
November 3rd at St. Paul's, what time?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
That's a very brave thing to do.
You know, like I said, the first part of Catholic Pentecostal was Catholic. And I know, I remember, yeah, you kept your mouth shut if you were, I've already got scars from that ruler. I don't need any more. I got some more of those little pieces of paper. There's one for $150.
Wow.
There's one for $50.
Wow.
There's one for $50. I just love those little pieces of paper. That's so precious. Also, we've got ones. I heard that some of y'all were saying that you were out of ones. We've got some ones right here, and she will sell them to you. So she's got a couple of hundred. She'd love for you to come and buy some of her ones so you can give back to the girls. So there you go. Thought I'd do that. So we're going to keep it moving. What do you say?
Yeah.
We're going to bring you to the stage. This gal, I get the pleasure of working with her at Chelsea's Brunch at Soundbar once in a while, and she is just... She's so much fun. She just absolutely, she's my sister. We just cut up. So she's going to cut up. I've already heard the song she's doing. Lord, help us, Jesus. She's going to cut up. Give me strength. Hallelujah. Thank you, Miss Jada Mack.
Satan's trying to stop me and to place my
Thank you for taking us to church, Miss Jada. Yes, ma'am. Jada Mack, everybody.